So with Erica Mukisa, who was delivered from the powers of darkness, and in her book Erica Part One, 7 Years in Hell, to quote something that was rather weird and scary here, you say that my hair was terribly abnormal. At night, it would grow very long, going all the way down my back. But during the day, it was short and it would break easily. And you say, I never cut it, but it would never grow during the day. I only had normal hair only after my deliverance, and I would say every lie possible at school in order to keep my hair from being cut. Whoa, tell us about this. Your hair would grow longer in the night?
Like one time I was going to perform in a club during karaoke, and then I met with my auntie. So when she saw me, she held my hand and she was, like an auntie. Yeah, she began to ask where I was going at that hour, in the night, indecently dressed. But when she looked at me, she saw my hair was very long and she said, "Oh, I'm sorry, I was mistaking you to be my daughter because you look alike. It's just that your hair is
So long.
so long and you look like my daughter. Wow, tomorrow I'll go and tell her I saw someone who looks exactly." She couldn't believe.
But it was you.
When she came home the following day, I hid from her because it was me, but she didn't know, she had no idea. Then it happened again. My brother, I was going to still perform in another event at a place called Silver Touch. It was in Jinja by then. So my brother, when he saw me, I was indecently dressed with some celebrities and he felt uncomfortable. So he tried to come and, stop me from doing whatever I was doing. But these guys could not allow him get to me because I had guards. You know, when you're going to dance and you're a queen dancer, the way you're dressed, you attract very many men to come
Men,
after you.
right.
So most cases they give you bodyguards. So they thought he was just coming to disorganize my performance.
Right. So they bounced him.
Yeah, and then he ran home to report me. But when he came home to report, he found me in the bedroom. And when he found me in the bedroom, that was the end of my friendship with my brother.
Wait, you were in two places at the same
At the
time?
same time, yeah. Because now what was happening is that they were now using my soul and my body. And these people that have sold their souls to the devil have the ability to perform in different places at the same time. You find that this artist has about 9 shows in one night, 9 concerts. So in some places, of course, they are going to use that person's soul. But you'll be with the people they are entertaining, will be looking at them like they are looking at people. Because those places are altars, as I said. You find there is a place, the meaning of that place is dark angels. So people are dancing with people, but some of the people they are dancing with are not normal, they are not human beings. There's an incident of a certain artist. A lady filed a case against him that he had raped her. And when they tried to find out, to investigate, this artist was denying. He said, "That time I was in Moana Hotel. I was performing." And when they tried to investigate, that same night, when the woman was claiming that he raped her, he was performing in Moana Hotel. But because he knew he had done it, he gave this woman 2 million. Now, why would you give someone you did not rape 2 million if it was not real? And it was covered like that. So there are certain things these people can do and they walk out free. But
Right, they get away with it.
if you try to imitate them, for you will be imprisoned. Yeah, there are certain things like drugs. Try to shoot a video with drugs and see if police won't look for you. But some of them, because they are working for some people,
Right.
they are going to be covered and protected. And if you try to talk about them, you will be the one to be imprisoned.
Well, then, interesting story here, but you did share about how you got into the act. And in school, you mentioned that you don't even know how.
How I passed.
Who sat for these exams?
What happened was this. In my class, mm-hmm. there was a boy called Mugisha Eric.
Okay.
And a Mukisa Erica.
Okay.
So we had our index numbers were, like if he's 88, I'm 189, he's okay. 188. Right. And this guy was gifted in sciences.
Okay.
Yeah. So what happened, what I remember when I was doing my senior four exams is that I possessed the boy and he thought he was in love with me. So during the time for exams, he wrote my name on his paper. He did the exam for me, and then we switched the papers. I gave him mine, and as soon as he was starting on his, they said time up. So I ended up doing that. He failed, yet he was brilliant, and he had to redo the exams the following year. So basically, that's how I was passing. Like, I would cause the students to sleep, and then make the paper to, you know, like face my direction. I copy everything, like, and I would always sit next to the brilliant kids. So I used to do a lot of evil until when one day I failed on certain missions, like in church, because I would also go to church on Sunday with my mom. Mm-hmm. It was a must at home. We had to go to church on Sunday. So I had failed in a mission of, like, I had been sent to attack a certain pastor. So I failed in that mission. Mm-hmm. And after failing in that mission, I had to sacrifice, you know, mm-hmm. by causing accidents. If I had failed in any mission, a certain road, like, would have accidents for a certain period of time. You'll find, like, there are accidents on Masaka Road. Like, and it is ever in news, eh? Mm-hmm. An accident happened, but on the same street. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the enemy wanting blood for sacrifice, because that is what empowers them to operate in every generation, because this person who is dying has energy mm-hmm. for that period of time. So they drink the life of that person. They don't drink the blood. That's why you see the blood on the ground, but the Bible says the life of the flesh is in the blood. So what they're doing is to drink the life of that person.
Okay. Yeah, so Erica, wow, too bad we're running out of time, but yeah. Yet there is a lot to tell, and I have some viewer questions here that we shall get into shortly. But real quick, your turning point, how did you meet God?
I had visited my uncle. I wanted to go to a certain school mm-hmm. and initiate pastor's children. I had initiated about 994 people into Satanism. During promotions, I was working for some companies that manufacture cosmetics mm-hmm. that have poisonous chemicals, and people are getting cancer. I was working for a certain company that is supplying drinks where they put poison and people get cancer. Mm-hmm. You know, it is increasing, but they create sicknesses and they transport them here on earth. So during that time, I was sent to go to a certain school and initiate some pastor's children.
Right.
So I visited my uncle who stayed in Kampala mm-hmm. and he happened to be a pastor. So I found that every night they would pray. And during that time of prayer, I would feel weakened mm-hmm. in the spirit. So every time they would pray, I would like doze off. Yet in reality, from the time my soul was initiated, I never slept.
You were always awake?
You can't sleep when your soul is out of your body. That's why the Bible says, to them that God loves, he gives sweet sleep. Even if you try to sleep, demons strangle you. You don't have peace at all. Jesus. That's why an artist says, "Guno mutima gukwagala ate gwo gukubye chuma. Ogambo njagala naye ate bumalunkabya." You know, they are talking about that devil who causes his people, like people who serve him, he doesn't even protect them. Mm. Yeah, so at that point, when I visited my uncle, he started now praying for me.
Right. He knew what was going on.
He knew that I was sickly. Okay. So he said, "I've prayed for many people and their situation has become better. So let us believe God for your life. I feel like I want to pray for you. So when he prayed for me, I fell down and I began rattling like a snake down. And he was shocked. The whole family was shocked. They stood on the chairs. They were like looking at, it was unbelievable. A daughter of a minister in the church falling down and, you know, manifesting like that. Then later when the prayer like intensified, because they did not pray for me in one day. Every day he started praying for me. The other day I vomited hair. They were shocked. They were like, how can a human being vomit hair? Then every time he would pray for me, he would call my mom and report. Okay. I prayed for your girl and this is what happened.
So was your mom shocked?
My mom was shocked. She also decided to pray and alert other pastors to pray. So it wasn't only one person that prayed for me. It reached a point where the whole church had to, the whole church fasted for 40 days. And now on the final day of fasting is when I got delivered. God just told them to fast, but they didn't know what they were fasting for. I believe it was me. So that day, I think Lucifer found out that I was going to escape. So he started strangling me. I was in the girl's room and I started getting strangled. But I tried to scream for help. My voice was not coming out. Like one of our former artists, the way he died. I think they would have found me down on the ground. So that's the time they started praying for me. Manifestation was so long, it took the whole night, and the church was in prayer. Then after Lucifer manifested in the house, pastor had never seen Lucifer, but that day when he manifested, even some Muslims in the neighborhood came and gave their lives to Christ. They said, with what we have seen, we just need to get saved. And my grandfather got saved. And they also started praying. If pastor would say fire, they would also say fire and hide behind the pastor. So I got my deliverance, but people were scared of me. I had dreadlocks in different colors. So when they prayed for me, my hair would go up and they think they are praying for a demon. But I thank God it's my uncle who prayed for me, because if it was someone else, they would run away from me.
Right.
Yeah, so after my deliverance, I asked my uncle, I told him, who delivered me? Well, I saw Angel Michael. I've been fighting with angels, but this time Angel Michael said, I have come for your deliverance and I'm taking you to your body. So it's Angel Michael that God sent to get my soul and bring it back to my body. Something that I had longed for a long time. And when my soul came back into my body, the first thing I said, who delivered me? So when my uncle said, it's Jesus, I said, how can I serve this Jesus? How can I pay him back? When does he come? Because Lucifer, the other side, has been coming and giving us assignments. And that day, one of the leading witches had announced that all the witch doctors gather in a certain hotel in Mukono, and I was supposed to be ordained as the greatest sorcerer in the country. So that is the day God delivered me. Now, when he said, it's Jesus, I said, what do I do to get Jesus? He said, you need to give your life to him. So I knelt down, made a confession. I felt joy, drank water, slept. Something I had never done all the time I served the devil.
People attempted to join the dark world or the underworld
because of those desperate kinds of situations. Like poverty can cause someone to become so desperate.
So it's for wealth?
Yeah, wealth. Some of them are initiated due to covenants that their parents still entered into in search for power.
Right.
Them.
So it's not their will, but they find themselves in this covenant.
Yeah.
Okay. And all right, here, have some of these people that you know, express the need to exit
many
and give their lives to Christ or do very, it differently?
Very many of them. Some of them have gotten saved, but
amen.
Yeah, some haven't gotten that boldness to come out.
What would you tell such a one?
I encourage them to stand, to stand firm, because the journey is not smooth, but when you stand firm, the enemy will eventually give up.
Well, that's right. Okay, and then where is your judger now?
She died during my deliverance. It backfired on her, so she died.
The same time?
Yes, the same time. It was a matter of life and death. It's not easy. You know, it's easy to become a Satanist, but it's difficult to get out. But I thank God I was among the lucky ones.
That's right. And then you're married now. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, so someone wants to know, how did your husband take in all this?
Yeah, my husband is a former secular artist.
Okay.
Who also got his other side of experience.
Right. Well, and you know, we shall host him on a different day so we can
for him
hear his
he experienced it at an international level. He was working with the Akon and those artists. Yeah, so he discovered the secrets, that things that happened behind the scenes.
So when he got to know about this,
he had my testimony and he tried to compare it with his life.
Right.
And he realized there are certain things that we have in common, you know, certain experiences he went through that I also went through.
All right.
Yeah, so and we started
both
ministry together.
Christ.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm so sorry I won't be able to ask all the questions because of time. We're out of time, but...
Ministry,
what are you doing? And tell us briefly about these books and where we can get them.
We are available. You can reach out to me on my Facebook page, Erica Belinda Ministry. There are phone numbers that you can call if you want us. +256 70 68 25 262 or +256 70 40 73 442. Kenyan number, because we are ever traveling. Yeah, so my Kenyan number is +254 799 733 775 or +254 710 62098.
Okay, and
email.
In case you're on social media, what's your handle?
The email is TimSimonKimani@gmail.com or ericamukisa@gmail.com. You can email us.
Yeah. All right. Oh, you can inbox us through the show's page. That's Mission 316 Show. And then we shall advise on how you can get through
it's
to
also,
them. And the books.
It's available on Amazon Kindle and Bazaar Bookshop in Entebbe.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. That's pretty much it. And Erica here would like to give out a book, a free book, to one of the lucky viewers of the show. And it's very easy, in case you want to get yourself this book, it's very easy. First of all, like the page, like the Mission 316 Show page, or if it's Twitter, still follow the page, that's Mission 316. And then after, what should we ask? And the very, well, let's see, the first person to like the page or to follow. We shall make it that easy, right?
Yeah.
Because everything else is out there. Yeah, we shall do that. Well,
I would love to hand this book over to you.
You're
welcome.
Thank you very much. Such a lovely lady. Well, stay with me. The show still continues.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
To give a free copy to one of the lucky viewers. Quick reminder, the place to go is Facebook or Twitter. If you are on Twitter, follow me, Olivia Ziwa. Follow me, Olivia Ziwa. Single Z at Olivia Ziwa. That's my handle. And if you are on Facebook, yeah, you have to like the show's page. That's Mission 316. Actually, you have to do both. The winner, I should see you on Twitter, follow Olivia Ziwa, and then I should see you on Facebook, following and liking the show's page, Vision 316, and it will be that easy. The very first person